shit! Limos!
I'm a brainless sales associate who gets by because I've got a great rap.
What exactly are we doing, man?
Listen, Louise, no offense, but I don't know how much I'm allowed to tell you.
What you mean, Abby? Tell me everything you know.
Really? I mean, how much information are you privy to? You're just a fucking driver, after all.
Yeah, I'm privy enough to know that you're a piece of shit who's using Tony and you're only gonna be hanging around for 2 to 3 months before Tony moves on to another chunk. I'm privy to the fact that the coke in your nose and the roids in your veins are gonna send you worse out of control real soon. I'm also privy to the fact that you're gonna be some fat trailer park queen back in the Midwest before you hit 30. Now tell me what the fuck we doing right now!
That attitude's not gonna get you anywhere, sweetie. You better say something nice to me.
Tell me what's fucking happening.
If you say something nice, I'll think about it.
You can get Tony fucked up like no one else can, Evan. That nice enough?
Oh, sweet. Thank you, Louise. Tony is more fun when I'm around. What do you wanna know?
What are we doing going to the docks in Isu?
Buying diamonds, $2 million worth.
Ivy, man, where did Tony get that kind of cash, bro?
You don't know everything, do you, Louise?
Yeah, I know that money can't be his unless he borrowed it. Where's it from?
Who the fuck should I know? I'm the looks, not the accountant.
Oh yeah, I forgot. You just stored the money. You don't know where it comes from.
The money could be Rocco's, it could be Gracie's. Who cares? We're getting some ice, baby.
Yeah, I don't like the sound of this, bro.
See what I mean? Always so serious. Don't worry for once. Tony skimmed 10% off the agreed amount, so we'll have some spending money.
Whoop, whoop.
Gonna hit the shops today, baby.
Even fucking better, bro. Even better.
Today on the subway, when an angry mob took exception to his refusal to stop playing air guitar while he listened to his MP3 player. Apparently, after repeated requests to stop annoying everybody, the man was turned on by a mob and ripped apart. This man was at the scene.
It was brilliant. This guy was a real jackass, acting like a fool and annoying everybody. And suddenly, the crowd took matters into...
Here's what Tony said to meet him.
At one point, a secretary bit his arm until blood started pouring out, while a pair of German tourists throttled him. A big woman from Bohan sat on his face and suffocated him. And then, people shredded his remains. It was awesome. It was...
Hey, what's going on?
future of communications. The Wiz Wireless Digital Extreme Camera Phone Flip. What's in your Wiz Flip?
Here's a picture of an old lady having a seizure.
Here's a picture of a famous person's vagina.
Connect. Live now. This is the moment. The Wiz Wireless Digital Extreme Camera Phone Flip.
I'm a supercilious cunt. And now everyone knows it.
Wiz Wireless. Do the social vibe.
Helicopters of death. Mike Whiteley is at the scene.
That's right. If pieces of people are flying out of the sky, send old Mike. It's not like I have family or anything. The National Office of Security Enforcement has been cagey about reports of an incident involving Annihilator helicopters exploding and agents falling to their death from the top.
Someone's going to have to take another advanced driving course, Louise.
Initial reports suggested the explosions happened during a bungled attempt to entrap a high-profile suspect on wiretap. But these claims have subsequently been denied. A new spokesman talked to us earlier in the day.
The official line is it was just a PR stunt. Special effects was all you saw up there. We don't throw those kinds of resources at a sting just to bungle it. No way that can happen. I don't know what people have told you about informants codenamed Desert Falcon or Sandfly, but they bear no connection to Mr. Ahmed Khalil and Mr. Tahir Saeed. Mr. Saeed's suicide was an unrelated, if unfortunate, incident.
We'll stay on this story unless we get distracted by a celebrity death. News.
And now for some good news. A hipster was killed last night outside a dive bar in East Hook. Tensions between broker locals and the hipsters who have taken up residence in their neighborhoods have started to boil over in recent weeks. 32-year-old Jude Corbin had his handlebar mustache ripped off before being beaten to death with his own skateboard. The assailant said he was sick of outsiders moving in with their pointy elf shoes, tribal buttons in their earlobes, and organic egg white breakfasts. Police have no leads. Jenny Acorn, Weasel News.
Want to go see a great sci-fi or war movie? Good luck. Vinewood has canceled production of all action blockbuster movies.
Stop driving like a prick, Lopez!
I'll take you home.
What happened to Evan?
He went the other way with those diamonds. Probably on the next plane to Los Santos, if you ask me.
He's not answering his phone. I'll check his bleeder.
You really think Evan's dead?
I'm sure of it. He bleated, didn't he?
Sorry, bro.
Those diamonds are gone too, Lou. We're really in this shit now. Got no more cards to play. What the fuck is going to go wrong next?
Stay cool. And don't get too fucked up on those pills. Or that charge. Or any fucking new shit. Hey, Evan ripped you off and he didn't get away with it. Look at it like that. I'll come see you soon.
Sure, whatever. So long, stranger.